Yeah, vlog 50, okay, let's get started. Welcome back to another video, guys. It's been a very long time since I uploaded. The previous video is the problems of online learning. If you haven't checked it out yet, go and check it out.
Shameless plug.
Also, thank you for 700 subscribers. You guys are amazing. I'm filming this video in advance, so I may be a little bit off. If you want to learn how to make Hollywood standard films, this is the wrong video to watch. But if you want to know what an amateur YouTuber like me uses to make YouTube videos, then yeah, you came to the right place. About a month ago, I recorded a segment of me talking about my YouTube equipment, and I thought it was pretty interesting, so that is what you're about to watch today. So without further ado, I hope all of you enjoy this little show and tell video, and let's roll the clip. Okay, we are in the room, it is nighttime, and I'm actually filming this at 11 p.m. at night. This is probably going to be my 50th vlog. Yes, we've done 50 of these videos, and you should already know by now that
I have a YouTube channel.
I'm also a student, yeah, I study mass communication, whatever that is. Right now, I want to do this little show and tell segment. I want to show you guys the equipment I use for YouTubing. Yes, YouTubing is a word I checked. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started. Cameras. What camera do you use to make your YouTube videos? Okay, I mentioned this before in the Q&A video, but the main camera I'm using right now is the Sony A7, and it looks like this. Sorry, that might be a little bit blur, so here's some B-roll. 80 to 90% of the time, I will use this camera. The Sony A7, in my opinion, is really nice for videography, but this is not my first camera. The very first camera that I use for this channel is the Canon EOS M, which is the one I have over here. This camera, compared to the Sony A7, this is way more compact. It actually still works. Unfortunately, there's no card inside, so I can't take any pictures right now. But this was a really good starting point. This is a vlogging camera. The very first vlog that I filmed with this camera is the one where I made a foil ball, I think. I think it was vlog number 9. That was 2 years ago. The lens on this camera is a wide angle lens, so it's basically made for those action shots, kind of like a GoPro. But this camera is made by a company called HTC, and unfortunately, they stopped production. I'm not so sure why, but you can't really get this camera anymore. It's not meant to be the best vlogging camera, okay? It's just meh. And it really only works well when you're outdoors and there's a lot of light. In low light situations, the video quality is just oh yeah, and it's actually broken. I think I dropped it too many times. It can't work anymore, okay? So that's why I can't use it. Anyway, let's talk about tripods. I have a few tripods, okay? So let's just quickly go through them. This is one of the tripods. It's made by a brand called PhotoPro. It's sturdy, it's heavy duty. It doesn't really extend that far. So as you can see, this is the maximum length. I only use this when I want to take low level shots or when I want to put my camera on top of a table like this. So it's quite handy, but the tripod that I use most of the time is the one I'm using right now. Compared to the previous one, obviously this is a lot higher, so it's more practical. I use it a lot more often. What I like about this tripod is it is partially made out of carbon, so it is not only sturdy, it is also lightweight. We've gone through cameras and tripods, now let's talk about lighting and audio. Very important. To make your YouTube videos look nice, you don't even need to get those flashy studio lights. You can even use normal lamps, which is what I still use today. There's three types of lighting that I use for all of my YouTube videos. Number one is natural lighting, which means I just sit in front of a big window and shoot during the daytime. Number two is lamps. We have a few lamps in the house and they can be really good for artificial lighting for videos. In fact, right now I'm actually using a lamp. This one is attached to my table. And then we come to this thing, the ring light. Ever since I got the ring light, I've been using it as the key light for my videos along with the lamps. What I like about it is because it's LED, it doesn't overheat, and you can actually adjust the brightness of the light, and it's not that complicated to set up. And now we move on to the last topic, audio. I recently got a mic online. I'm using it right now. It is the Rode VideoMic Pro. I started to use this mic since the previous video, and if the audio quality sounds a little bit different than my other videos, please bear with me, okay? I apologize. I'm still trying to figure some things out. Hopefully, it's not that bad. Alright, that basically wraps it up for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed this little show and tell segment. If you enjoyed this video, definitely hit that like button down below. If you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, definitely consider. Tons of new stuff coming soon. Before this video ends, I'd like to ask, do you own any video equipment? And if you do, is there anything that you'd like to recommend to us? Leave them down in the comments below. Alright, that's about it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, I will see you in my next video. Take care.